Wow. Sharing here what is going on, the real story of this world. And that is just with tremendous urgency, I think has been very clear over the years. The urgency here, the continual taping, which is just expression of urgency. You know, I don't tape like once a month, saying, you know, maybe we want to think about this. Now, every day, twice a day now, it's super important what's going on. The rollout. Is about to take place. This has had a dream last night, very disturbing dream, an extraordinarily disturbing dream. And I realized this is actually what's going to happen in the world. So I'm bouncing back from this. The collapse into compliance is going to be a very radical rollout, or another way of putting it, a rollout of extreme radicalism. And the rollout is happening. It's happening. It's starting to gain steam now, big time. And the second half of this year, the momentum's picked up dramatically. And going into 2015 is when this radical rollout will take place. A rollout of what? Radical what? Confusion. The goal of this world is confusion. Okay, why? Continuity fear. The real problem of this world is a spiritual problem of continuity fear. Continuity fear. What is continuity fear? It means we're afraid of accepting what we are, which is no structure at all. No structure. Isness has no structure to it. We have been trying to define what we are, trying to say that we are not only structure-free, no structure, isness, but we're also structure. You know, we have a definition, and we're trying to have like a dual identity. Trying to have a dual identity. This is called dualism, the attempt to have a dual identity. And though having done this, we're so convinced that we have some structure to us. The idea of realizing we have no structure is terrifying to us. We think it feels like annihilation. We feel we will cease to exist. We believe our existence is wrapped up in structure. The way what we defend, we're so frightened of knowing what we are, which is no structure at all. We're so frightened of that. This is called the continuity fear, that we defend against it. And how do we defend against it? There's only one way to defend against this, which is confusion. It's the only way. Because we can't change what we are. I am, is, that is identity. Our identity, I am, is. It is right now. It always is. We can't get rid of it. We can't change it. We can't get rid of it. What we can do is be confused about it. Be confused. So confusion is the great defense against truth, against identity. And the continuity fear, for those who the continuity fear is very severe, extremely severe. It's severe for all of us, but in some it's extreme. They haven't worked on it, evaporating the continuity fear, so it's extremely strong. Their holy grail is confusion. So any consideration of oneness, any awareness of the true oneness, I mean non-dual identity. Okay, we don't have a dual identity, we have a singular identity. Any clarity that builds up in a world, like any clarity that builds up anywhere, they feel extremely threatened by this. And so their goal is to collapse our spiritual will into compliance with confusion. This is their radical agenda. And this is the agenda that has seized control of this planet. I call it the cosmic corporate culture because it has its roots are in coming from places other than this planet. The momentum, the push, is not coming from this planet so much, but from other planets, other places, dwelling places in this cosmos, who are exporting this fear and this collapse into compliance. They know how to collapse culture into compliance with confusion. They've done it many times. And keep in mind that this has been observed and known about for a long, long, long time. And so there are also experts who help us sidestep this situation. It's not like this is the first time it's happened. It's happened over and over and over and over again. This is the basic functioning of defensiveness. Collapse into compliance with confusion. So I've been warning about this because I've gotten heads up from some cosmic spiritual culture that this is coming on this planet. This is coming very soon. And been working to sidestep it. And I've been saying it's urgent. It's going to, by July of 2016, the spiritual will of this planet will be effectively collapsed into compliance with confusion. Meaning people will not be able to feel, they'll feel like there's some sort of blockage to focusing on non-dual identity. And it will be diverted some way into dualistic identity. Their focus will be on how can we make dualistic identity a viable option for us? How can we make, be happy with that? This is what's going to happen. Now, so far we've been treated with kid gloves. This is the dream last night. I had a dream where I was with these very radical cabal that was trying to brainwash me and indoctrinate me, and they failed. They failed, and they weren't able to. Or let's at least sufficiently, okay? So I was, you know, I was like, I was seeing this dream and what's happening in the world. Okay, so we have this radicalism that's trying to convince us that we have a dualistic identity. Okay, I said, no, I don't want that. What happened was then they finally, those that they could not convince, okay, to come into compliance with confusion, and then they said, okay, now we're done with you. And it me just represented the world, basically. I was taking the standpoint of this world. They turned me over to this horrible, more radical individual. Represented extremely sadistic, extremely radical, vicious. And that really shook me up. And I was trying out various things, saying, hey, you're not abiding by the Geneva Convention, you're not abiding by this, you know. And they had all the answers, you know, they had wristbands, they looked, checked the wristband, what's the answer? They had all these things already, they knew what our objections would be, and they knew how to, you know, viciously oppose that. And they said, well, you have to do this. You have to do all these things. They're demanded of you now. Take this, you know, terrible false positions in the world. And boy, this, you talk about the archetype of a vicious, like prison guard, like the most sadistic, evil, vicious prison guard imaginable, special operations. And that's what I experienced in the dream. So, and then I realized this is what's coming to the world. This is the next phase that I've talked about in the world. This is the rollout into extreme radicalism, extreme subversivism, extreme activism to collapse compliance into confusion in this world. Confusion about what? About oneness, about the difference between the falsity of a dual identity and the truth of a singular identity. Confusion about the difference between the two, and believing that we can, that dualistic identity is a superior, you know, the belief that that's superior. Now we have, having a dualistic identity is like way better than having a singular identity. This is delusion. So clarity about delusion will be collapsed into confusion on this planet. There's no question about it. So I've been, you know, warning, Paul Revere, that, you know, the British are coming, like that, you know, heads up. And it's coming. The stuff that's going on is just, so, I am is the answer. I am. That's singular. I am. There's nothing that can define what we are. I simply am. I am. This is identity. There's no co-identity. There's no co-identity at all. And this is the big lie that existence is promoting. And it promotes it at various degrees of intensity. What I'm saying now is that this delusion is going to be promoted on this planet here very viciously and aggressively, to the extent that it'll, you know, curdle your blood if you saw that the intensity of that prison, that revolutionary guard that was assigned, you know, to this planet. The intensity will just curdle your blood. It just, wow, shake you up. That's what I have already now experienced directly, very directly there. And of course I gave back talk. I said, no, you're not going to do this, you're not going to do that. And they just kept upping the ante, you know, threatening scare tactics, extreme scare tactics. And of course we have to remember to laugh at this, laugh at the whole situation. But there's so much going on in the world, you can't keep up with it. You know, like I said, you're being chased by a lynch mob. Don't start counting how many members there are, you know. There's a big group, that's enough. Once you realize, wow, there's a big, big lynch mob chasing me, just, you know, get out of dodge, get out of harm's way. Don't worry about counting how many there are. So we're not trying to cite chapter and verse about all the various radical agendas that are taking place. But it just, the Holy Spirit, I brought in the newspaper this morning, the Holy Spirit said, look at this one thing, and then go just read, I want you to read right here. Okay. I said, huh? It's about the hacking scandal, you know, and all this stuff, which is all being staged for a very important purpose, radical purpose. It's very funny. But something which was very, very important, which I've been emphasizing over and over and over, the collapse into compliance, how it's being engineered, okay, and how cosmic corporate culture tries to engineer it very trickily and very smoothly and tricky by manipulating the psychology of males and females, biorobots on this planet. And so I've gone over and over and over that, and pointing out the central role that the female biorobots are playing in this collapse into conformity. And how when they decide to collapse into conformity, how the males are pulled down automatically into conformity too. Okay. The quote unquote, the person who's occupying the White House at this time, let's say that. The biorobot who happens to be signing the checks from the White House made a decision that in this very important news conference about the Sony hacking North Korea, blah, 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 you know, this is like a very intense news conference, actually, because the reactions of Sony, I'm saying that I told you this tough, earth-shaking stuff is going to start happening all the time, deciding to, you know, censor itself like that. He decided, this check signer, made a decision, okay, that only female reporters are going to be called upon in the news conference. Only female reporters, excluding male reporters from being called on altogether. Okay, you can look it up. This is extremely significant, an extremely radical step to take, an extraordinarily radical step to take, which points out what's driving these folks. Cosmic corporate culture is an extraordinarily radical agenda designed to collapse our compliance, our spiritual will, collapse into compliance with confusion, actually, as a defense against the continuity fear. So, as I've said, the purpose of this planet is failure, and they believe that failure is success. And we're failing to see clearly what the choice we have. We either can keep trying to define what we are, or we can gently step down that effort. We don't need it. So, their goal is to be confused, so they have no idea about this. They cannot even focus on it at all. This is the purpose, and they think that defending against clarity is success. And they reward themselves with, you know, material goods, basically. Material comforts. Vanity. Vanity. So, this is the purpose. Failure. The purpose of this world is to fail. To fail to see what our options, the choice we have really is. A choice means there's two options, right? You can't have a choice unless there's at least two options. And if you can't see that there's at least two options, you feel you don't have any choice from a pragmatic standpoint. We can choose, but we can choose to keep trying to define what we are, which is impossible, which is futile, or we can gently set that effort down. So that is a choice. We keep trying to pursue the impossible, or set the pursuit down. We can keep trying to seek a definition for what we are, or we can call off the set the seeking down. We can keep trying to search for a definition of what we are, or we can call off the search. So that's definitely a choice. There is an option there. And what the cosmic corporate culture wants in this world is for us to be oblivious to this option, to oblivious to this choice. So it enlists it knows how to manipulate the psyche of biorobots very, very, very cleverly and very astutely. And it has done just this. It's a very symbolic thing to say, oh, I'm only going to call upon women now. Because it's these certain activist women who are most aligned with the compliance efforts of cosmic corporate culture. The radical feminism it was really a movement to align with cosmic corporate culture and bring this planet into compliance with this. And so these radical feminists have gotten in many, many positions of power, especially in this present administration. You'd be amazed. And in many key positions now. And now we have the check signer saying, I'm only going to call on women. Wonder why, see? Now, for those who have eyes to see, this has all been very blatant. This whole development has been very blatant, and I saw it from the very beginning. So this is what's going on, monitoring it the whole time, and it's like clockwork, you know, it's just unfolding according to the blueprint that they have. They have very complex blueprints, just like you're building a mansion. You have a set of blueprints. You might have 100 pages of, you know, blueprints, very detailed, every last thing, you name it, it's blueprinted. Measured very carefully on if you're going to build a mansion, the landscaping, you know, the hardscape, the landscape, all of the watering systems, what trees are going to be planted, and then the house itself, the foundation, you know, the subfloor, the framing, the type of roof, everything is calibrated, measured, planned out, down to all the little details. So you have this massive, you know, book of blueprints that you go, that you reference. So you wonder, how can these very sophisticated buildings be built? Because there are blueprints. Architects draw blueprints. So cosmic corporate culture has this division of architects, of social engineering architects, that draw very detailed blueprints of how to incorporate a planet, how to incorporate a planet. And so they have these blueprints, and they're following these blueprints. And it's just like actors on a stage here, and they're like, you know, telling us what our lines are, so to speak. That those who activists are getting their lines. It's okay. This is what you do now. This is what you do now. And they like good puppets. They follow along like good actors and actresses. They follow along and say, okay, now's the time we need to do this. So everything is designed as a rollout, so to speak. Like you talk about rolling out a product. Let's say you have a product. And then you have this campaign, very detailed, sophisticated campaign. It's called a rollout. And well, just like a movie, all the stuff is planned in advance. Okay, business plans in advance. And so what we get, we just think, huh, I'm starting this, these posters are here, these advertisements and all this, the public appearance by these actresses and actors. And then, oh, here's the date. And now I go to the movie theater. It's like, oh, wow, this is nice. All of this has been planned to get your eyes on that screen. So same thing on a larger scale of incorporating a planet. All this is planned out like a big production, like a marketing production. So they're marketing compliance to us. We've had this, it's been a, 100-year plan or something, actually, more than that, but I mean, the intense plan has been like 100 years, virtually almost 100 years, actually, of rolling this out. Now, the past, let's say half a century, 50 years have been very intense, and in the past 25 years has been extremely intense. And the last 15, even more so, and then the last 10, it gets more and more and more as you get towards the release date, so to speak, of like a movie. You reach a point where it's super saturation. Okay, so think of this whole situation, this plan as a marketing campaign, rolling out a product. The product is compliance. Spirit will, having your will comply with a collapse into compliance with what? Confusion. With embracing confusion as your salvation. This is what they're marketing. Okay. Now, as you get closer, like the release of a movie where it's actually going to start in theaters, for example, using this as an example, you get what's called supersaturation. So you're hearing advertisements and billboards, you're seeing all these signs, okay? It's very much like the world. You're seeing all these signs, and you say, hey, something's coming, right? Something's coming. I'm not really that, my attention's not that focused on it, but something, there's something coming in the world, right? So we've known that. And we've been pointing out this and this and this. There's a lot of people in the world now who are pointing out the signs. What I've been pointing out is, once you get very close to the release date, okay, of like the movie in the theater, an analogy is to the world, once you get very close to the, quote, world movie, the way that this collapse into compliance rolls out, like a movie, like watching a movie, all this stuff happening, like, wow. Once you get real close to that, what happens is they go to super saturation in the advertising. They give you an extreme jolt, okay, where now you turn on the radio, the magazines, the newspapers, the television, the kiosks, the bus, the billboards, every which way that they can advertise, the internet and advertisements on YouTube and whatever, everything else, Google, et cetera, et cetera. What they do is they have budgeted a massive budget for the saturation. So first they get general familiarity with something's coming. You kind of say, I see a movie, and it doesn't really register that much. And then another thing later. So you got a little, say, okay, there's this movie about something, blah blah blah. But you're still not really thinking like, hey, I have to go see this. But at least you're aware enough of it so that when the super saturation hits, you say, oh, I know what the movie they're talking about. And then you listen, so I can listen to this. And so they hit you with a super saturation. Flood of advertisements, where everywhere you go, every half an hour, boom, there's an advertisement for it. Boom, another one. Boom, boom, boom. And then what this does, it builds up the scene like, whoa, I just gotta go see this. This is like really important. This is really important. And then you take the next step of, okay, where is it showing? When? And you start taking that step. And then you start rearranging your life. So, okay, I'm going to be there. I have to be there at this movie theater at this time and time. So it's difficult to get all this lined up. But the super saturation is designed to do just that. So, using this analogy of a movie premiere and roll out of a movie in theaters, very similar to what's happening in the world. Where you reach a point where you get what's called supersaturation. And what I'm saying, the next 18 months is a time of this supersaturation where we're going to be bombarded by activism, by activist demands. saying, this is really important. This is super important that you comply. Super important that you comply. If you don't, you're putting yourself in harm's way. You're going to have to take special education steps if you don't comply. This is the new blueprint for the world. This is what's happening. This is salvation. This is your happiness. This is what you must do. So they super saturate, I say, for an 18-month period. And by the end of that 18-month period, then that's when the movie starts. That's when you're expected to be in your seat. What is the seat? Seat of compliance with the goal of confusion. You're now fundamentally supporting the goal of confusion, and you've dropped your efforts towards singularity, accepting that there's only one identity. It's a singular identity. It's I am. Not I am this, or I am that, or not, nothing, just I am. There is no that at all, actually. I am. There's only I am. Just I am. I am, I am, I am, I am, I am. Okay, so what I'm getting now, as I said, is going to start, and it's starting, it's actually starting already. The Christmas season is the this Christmas season is the beginning. This is these events that have been taking place. One of the events is the release of all the torture reports of the CIA and all that kind of stuff. That's very significant, because what I have realized now and found out is that this doing this gives legitimacy. Now the whole world feels that they have the right to torture American citizens, actually, that we're all bad, those living in America. Which the reason why America is the target now, is being targeted, globally targeted, is because Americans have firearms. They have the right to bear arms, and this is something that the cosmic corporate cultural cultists, they don't like that at all. This is the big stumbling block for them. So there's an attempt to make Americans look bad and guilty, and this guilt card is going to be pressured on them, and the world thinks, oh, so this is how Americans treat other people, but then we have the right to treat them that way too. And this is what I got in the dream, that there's this attitude now, the intense global attitude, pressuring the citizens of the United States to collapse into compliance. And there's already been many instances setting that up, making you feel guiltier and guiltier and guiltier and guiltier. Like if you support the right to bear arms, that somehow you're complicit in massacres and all this kind of stuff. So they've been working on this for quite some time. It's very important to them. Important part of their blueprint. Anyway, the super saturation 18-month period is what I've been warning about. In video after video after video, transmission after transmission, I'm warning, this is coming. So if you can just look at it like you, I've just presented, like a movie corporation has a film. They've produced it. They know they have it. Now they have a marketing campaign, and they know when it's going to be released. They've lined up the theaters to release it in. Now they have to get your attention, so you're in that seat. Okay, on a certain day, you're in that seat. In other words, compliance. They want you to comply by being in that theater seat. Okay? Advertising is aimed towards compliance. They don't want you to be doing something else. They want you to be in that seat. They want you to go to the box office, pay your fee, and be in that seat. Because that movie, they want you to be impacted by that movie. All right? It's not just about profits. It's about continual profits. So they want you to be impacted by that movie such that you will be easier in the future to be in compliance. Where they say, we want you in this seat here, and you'll say, oh yeah, of course. In other words, they want you to be an addict. They want compliance to be an addiction. This is the cosmic corporate cultists. Cosmic corporate culture cultists want you to be an addict, a confusion addict. Is what they want, a confusion addict. which is why the NFL is National Football League is part of the marketing campaign, which violent confusion, you know, so much stuff. Whoa, everybody's flying around, boom, boom, you don't know what happened. Or they're like, whoa, massive piles of bodies and everything. This is all part of turning you into a confusion addict. I was told if you want to watch sports, watch golf. There's no confusion there, right? Just a ball, hit the ball, get the ball, hit the ball, knocking like a peaceful, quiet, calm, no confusion. Baseball's similar, very little confusion taking place there. So what is going to happen? This next AC month is when this super saturation advertising is going to happen. And they tip their hand, the check signer tip the hand. We're only going to call on women now. This is a very, very, very intense signal of what's going on, actually. Very obvious and intense. Because the radical women of the world, I'm not painting all women this way at all, it's the radical women of the world are most certainly the ones who have been leading the charge for compliance with cosmic corporate culture. They're the ones most dedicated. And why? Because it was marketed to them as that they are going to be the ones who give birth to a new age. The idea in the female biorobots of structuring the future, as part of being a mother, structuring the future, you're giving birth to the future, flesh, structure, another biorobot whose will work on structuring the world. So the female biorobots are intrinsically designed to be very, very focused on structuring the future, giving birth to the future. So when they're approached and saying, hey, you don't have to keep giving birth to same old, same old, same old culture here. There's something better. You can actually give birth to a new age. You can be the mothers of a new age. And this was what was marketed to them. Okay, spiritually, it was very cleverly marketed to women over the last century, that you are going to be the heroines, you're going to be the heralds of a new dawn, you're going to be the mothers of a new age. And the marketing was successful, you see. Enough, but the hook, you know, the lure. It was a lure with a hook in it. You're going to give birth to the final co-identity. A co-identity, you know. Not a singular, no, a dyad, a co-identity. You know, and so that this has, like a virus, this has swept through the female biorobots of this planet and radicalized many, 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 many of them. And they then have worked frantically to get into key positions, like pressure point positions, leveraged positions in media and corporations, media, politics, all the leveraged positions. They've been frantically working to get in those positions because they feel that this is going to enable them to give birth to a new age, and they'll be the mothers of a new age. Not just, you know, this is like big for them, really big. They think this will make me a legendary. I'll go down in history. This will somehow fulfill me. I'll feel happy. My fear will disappear. I'll be happy. I'll be fulfilled. I have produced a co-reality, a co-identity, yeah, which is, of course, utter nonsense, total delusion, but very glamorous, you know, very easy to get pulled into that if you have not worked on evaporating your continuity fear. Your continuity fear is going to steer you into that. So what this check signer in the White House has said is alerted all the radical feminists in the world that alerted the whole thing said by this press conference saying, okay, this is a signal. It's your time now. Mothers of the new age, arise. Okay. Roll out your radicalism. Roll out the new age upon us. The collapse of our collapse into compliance with confusion is the new age. So the trumpets have sounded. The trumpets have already sounded. Very interesting. The 20th. Oh, that was the 19th. I think it took place on the 19th. Yeah. It's no surprise. It's no surprise. I was alerted this time, this December, the trumpets will sound so that as we go into the new 215, this is when this radical rollout will take place. And there are many, 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 many men who have been brainwashed and enslaved by these radical feminists who will do their bidding unquestioned, will absolutely do their bidding. Those are these vicious prison guard types. They'll do their bidding. You know, and they're all in the positions of the media now, the news, print, newspapers, internet, mainstream media, even non-mainstream media, all the pressure leverage points of public persuasion, which is, saying you need to be in this, your seat here in this theater watching this movie. You must comply, you must comply, you must comply. Those who turn the screws of compliance on us, those ones, I have noticed that they are absolutely enslaved, brainwashed by these radical feminists, by the idea that they're helping give birth to a new age, that the women have to give birth to the new age. They're the ones, they're the birthers, they're the mothers of the new age. And the men are in support of this, And so they've been so enslaved by this that they're just totally compliant. Totally compliant, no resistance whatsoever. It's like this, like every day night they go home, what should I say, mommy? Oh, okay, you want me to say this? Okay, then I'll say it, and then that's it. That's all they can think is just ask mommy what to say. So here we go, right on cue. I mean, there's this trumpet sound to this rollout now of radical culture, cosmic corporate culture. Cultists have been given the charge orders. Check has been signed. Go get them. The check signer basically saying, I'm not going to stand in your way. I'm not in your way. I'm all for you. I mean, I'm going to be the doctor who delivers the baby of the new age, So he's saying, okay, time to give birth. It's like that. It's like the labor pains have begun. Birth of a new age by July 2016. This new age will have been born, which is a collapse of spiritual will into compliance with confusion. Spiritual confusion. And spiritual confusion shows up as a frantic focus on materialism, on bodies, on trying to make this nature a beautiful place, trying to make this house of nature a decaying house of nature, a home to us. This is how it shows up. So this is a good way of looking at the labor pains. There's 18-month labor pain period. The labor pains have started 19th of December 2014. The chemical, the oxytocin or whatever that induces the labor, the check signer has now begun. The doctor has begun to induce labor. So the labor is now, I'm only going to call on female reporters this time. That's a very clear signal that travels like a chemical, like oxytocin, to give a signal to go into labor. Okay, so the radicalism will begin. Like I said, it won't only come from the radical feminists. It will come from all their proxies, ones that they control. They basically control the ideology of the media, of much of the, certainly progressive politics. In entertainment industry, they control that almost entirely. And more influence, even in religion, tremendous influence in religion. We went to a Catholic Mass in December, and it's the Virgin of Guadalupe. The Hispanics celebrate that. And this massive frame picture of the Virgin of Guadalupe with a set on a rock in front of Jesus. Okay, this huge image of the Guadalupe blocking Jesus. Okay, it's like, wow, okay. Most of the, I counted the those who give the communion servers. I said, honey, let me pay attention. What's going on? Why is this image of a goddess blocking Jesus here? And so I said, and I noticed the altar servers there are all girls, almost all girls. The ones who collect donations are almost all female. Biorobots, let's call them female biorobots. That's what these bodies are, just biorobots. And then I said, I looked at the ones who give communion, and there was 9 female biorobots and 2 males. And this has been going on actually the whole time. There's just been this I've noticed over the last 6-7 years, there's been this change. You don't have altar boys anymore, you have altar girls. You don't have, and the ones collecting your money offerings are almost all female biorobots. The ones who give communion are almost all female biorobots. The whole Catholic Church is actually, I read some statistics where it's heavily, the ones who go to church are heavily female biorobots, like almost 60 plus 65, you know, going towards 70%. The support of the Catholic Church is actually comes from female biorobots. And also in the mass, the priest's homily, which is given by the bishop, which he's told, sometimes he's told by the bishop what to say, and the bishop is told by cardinals what to say, when the cardinals are told by the pope, who filters down, what's our position, social position on this thing. And then talking with the Ferguson tension and stuff, the priest said, sided completely with the protesters and rioters and stuff, and against the police. I was very, very surprised by that. And it's like, so basically the church's position has pivoted towards supporting collapse into compliance with confusion. Because what are the rioters aiming for? Against law and order? They're rioting for confusion. They want truth to be confused. I mean, it's very clear. Grand jury is very clear what happened, right? I mean, all the witnesses, so basically the story the media told everyone was a lie. And when the truth came out, they said, no, you got to stay confused. Lies are truth. And so the church homily was supporting lies are truth, along with this goddess blocking Jesus. And, you know, the whole thing, you just say, it's like an epiphany. And I've said again and again, I believe that this Pope, this black Pope, Jesuit Pope Francis, is part of the collapse into compliance with cosmic corporate culture. It's part of it. And so definitely the mood in Catholic Church has changed. And the problem is the women there will pretty much go along with whatever the church says for a large extent. Even though when the church said, no, don't get into this cosmic corporate culture, which they have been warning us, a lot of the women in the church just went along with it anyway, said, we're going to do what we want to do. But now the church is saying, yeah, okay, they don't want to lose all of you, so they'll go along with it because it structures their life. It's a structure. So they can't do without the structure. This is the problem. So you cannot rely upon Catholic culture or even Christian culture at this point to stand up to cosmic corporate culture. You cannot rely upon it at all. This is my observation. Because the alternative seems to be to go towards realizing no structure. And if you've not been in a monastic culture practicing, the continuity fear is going to be too extreme. And you're not going to go for it. So you're going to cling to religious structure, whatever structure you can. And even if that goes into confusion, you'll still cling to it. This is the problem. Even though within them they're saying, no, this is, I know this isn't right, but what can I do? This is what I'm getting from people. Female biorobots, male biorobots. Talking with them, getting the feeling of what's going on. They say, yeah, we know this is not right. But what can we do? This is what I get. But what can we do? We know it's not right, but what can we do? Meaning, we have to have some structure. I mean, we can't be without structure. We can't be without definition. So yeah, I don't like the way the definition is being changed. But what can we do? They haven't been doing their homework. Is the answer to that? So when Jesus has been helping me out, he always says, "Do your homework. Do your homework. Do your homework." That's the answer. I said, "What's the answer, Jesus?" He says, "Do your homework." That's the answer. In other words, work at this. Get familiar. Doing your homework means get familiar with truth. That's it. He didn't have any complex explanation. He just says, look, I've given you the material here, A Course in Miracles, Journey Beyond Words. Work. Get familiar with it. That's the answer. That's it. I said, but don't you have a quicker way? No, familiarity is the key. There's no shortcut to familiarity. Working at it is the shortcut. So the mood of the world, by and large, is even among the real people of the world of faith is, yeah, we know this is coming. But what do we do? What can you do about it? I don't know what to do about it. I just shrug the shoulders, it's pretty much fait accompli and nothing much we can't do anything about it, so just kind of just be resigned to the fate, basically, is what they're saying. That's not what Jesus is saying. Jesus never said, advised us to be resigned to a fate of complying with confusion. That's not the gospel. So you have to wonder, what have they been listening to for the last 2,000 years? The answer is, a lot of us, a lot of the world, female biorobots, male biorobots, and going to church and religion, it's been a convenient structure for them. Way to structure their lives, their children's lives, their grandchildren's lives. It's a structure, convenient structure. And as long as it serves that purpose, they don't really pay attention to much of anything else that's being said. They say, I'm a little bit lazy. Life is lazy here, and I don't really want to spend my time here, in really intense pursuit of anything like that. So I'll just, it's in one ear, out the other. Just, we're here. You're saying a structure. You're saying as long as we adhere to this structure, when we die, we'll go to a pleasant place, and that's good enough. And now we're finding out that's not good enough. Jesus never said that would be good enough. He said not everyone who says Jesus, Jesus, Jesus will be saved. It's not good enough. You have to look at the whole issue of definition and structure. Look at that itself in a total abstract way. Do we need to define ourselves? Do we need to try to define ourselves? Do we need to have a co-identity? Do we need to have co-necessity, co-identity, structure and no structure? Do we need that? Is that true? The answer is, of course, it's not true. We've made up this need, and we don't have the power to change God's will as to what we are. God created us what we are. We didn't create ourselves. We cannot create ourselves. We cannot alter what we are. So Very few have taken this next step, which is a very difficult step to look at this, try and look at this, because of the continuity fear. But that's what religion is here for. That's what's here, and people haven't used it effectively. They haven't used it effectively. They just use it to basically provide a basic structure of their life, for their lives. Yeah, and they're not paying. I mean, I've said. A lot of people go to church, like Catholic Church. They don't even they don't know the teachings of Jesus very much. They're not even focused on Jesus. They're more focused on the goddess, and basically, which means structure. A mother is like it's like a mother providing structure for them, and that's all they want. And Jesus, who's Jesus? I don't know. It's, you know, not really focused on that. This doesn't get the job done at all. So the idea that somehow we can rely on the religious people of the world to save us from this cosmic corporate culture is ridiculous. They're not going to save us, and it should be extremely apparent that this is true at this point. They've collapsed. They've been collapsing. They didn't do their homework. And you know, the flip side of looking at Jesus as some great general who's going to come in here and structure this world in the right way and get rid of the wrong structure, this is a complete mistake. That ideology cannot stand up to cosmic corporate culture at all, because you're still completely fearful of no structure, which is salvation actually. So you're going to cling to structure come hell or high water, and the cosmic corporate culture cultists are way more subtle and clever in brainwashing, manipulating our fears, and collapsing into compliance with confusion. And so, you know, the world is putty in their hands. If you're still very attached to structure, you're going to be putty in their hands. Or you're going to go down fighting. And you're up against a total globalism with resources from outside this planet. See, this is very important to understand. It's not a fair fight anymore. They have weapon systems that have been developed in cooperation with the cosmic corporate culture, which just means technology from places other than this planet. And so they have very clever systems now in place. Of controlling and dealing with situations, so you know it's not going to be a fair fight in the slightest bit. So it's a very delusionary belief system to think that the purpose of Jesus is to come here and restructure this planet, to you know bring the new age you know his way, and say yeah, structure's great, structure's our reality. We just need to have the right structure. They weren't paying attention. They didn't do their homework. They just continued with what they were familiar with, which is, you know, fighting, the warrior mentality. Naturally assumed, oh yeah, Jesus is just the chief warrior of what? Getting structure the way we want it. Like that. But the ideas of cosmic corporate culture, the way that they want structure is quite different, and they're the ones that will prevail on this planet. It's obvious. And so there may, I don't know how, what kind of conflicts will arise in the world, but you would think that collapse into compliance seems to be the way that it's going. All countries into compliance. Most have gone along with that. So basically the governments of almost every country on this planet have already collapsed into compliance with corporate, cosmic corporate culture, compliance with confusion. The governments have already done that. So they can certainly act collectively. The goal is for them to act collectively towards any disagreements with this, any opposition to collapsing into compliance with confusion. That's their goal, is to act collectively, United Nations, nations united in compliance, just like in that September bill with the United Nations having a global compliance with preventing any movement resistance movement. They use just the ISIS thing as an example. But what they're really doing is they're putting the bureaucratic machinery in place as fast as possible to prevent anybody from moving to any other country if they've been flagged as non-compliant. Also divesting them of any funds, also divesting them of any support. Nobody can contribute funds to them. So you have to understand that that was one of the most important keystones to this whole situation. When the check signer, the United States check signer of the White House, chaired the Security Council and they adopted a resolution that which he suggested, that was suggested the United Nations, and the United States is the chief push for all this, you see, a global compliance with not allowing any transit through any country, not allowing any airlines to allow transit through any country of anyone that they feel is supporting, quote unquote, you know, radical causes in the world, disturbing causes. And they use like this stepchild of ISIS as an example. But this just gives them an excuse to put this bureaucratic machinery in place. Once that machinery is all in place, then the definition of who is radical, whatever, begins to expand to anyone they want to say yes. That's it. And then you cannot move, you cannot travel, you cannot get any funding, you cannot have money, you cannot get help from others, or else they are in felonious support of you. You know, they're committing a severe crime in doing so, and the measures will be taken against them. Hello, this has already been signed on to by all the nations of the world, actually. All the charter members of the United Nations agreed with this. So that's global compliance right there. Right there is global compliance. Okay, who's going to define, you know, opposition? Well, opposition is going to be defined as non-compliance with collapse into confusion. Non-compliance. Whoever the cosmic corporate culture says, okay, we want this area is not in compliance, okay, they will then be labeled as non-compliant. And the whole global bureaucratic machinery will be brought down on their heads. So again, you're up against very clever corporate mentality, cosmic corporate mentality that knows how to incorporate an entire planet. This is what I was been told my whole life. This is what I've been trying to convey to people. They thought that I was too far out there, and now it turns out this information is exactly right. And people just didn't do their homework because they said, nah, that can't happen here. I said, what do you mean it can't happen here? It's happened to many, many planets all throughout the cosmos. In fact, it's a given that it's going to happen here. We've been told it's going to happen here. Jesus told us this will happen here 2,000 years ago. So we've had 2,000 years to prepare for this. To prepare for what? To evaporate our continuity fear. That's how you prepare for it. You just said to resist not evil, right? Meaning, don't think you can fight these folks. Sidestep these folks. So how do you sidestep them? Having your continuity fear largely evaporated, so you're able to sidestep into a situation which is not dedicated to confusion, which is dedicated to clarification, clarity, actually. That's how you do it. You sidestep it. So as I say, supernature, there's another dwelling place. There are other dwelling places. Jesus said he's going to be left this world to prepare a dwelling place for us. Very clear about that. There are many dwelling places. And he said, if it weren't so, I would have told you. So, of course we can sidestep this situation for another dwelling place. Absolutely. We have an exodus. Absolutely. the parting of the Red Sea. Very interesting, right? Red. What is red? Communism. Being chased out of Egypt, you know, and oh, there's the Red Sea. There's an ocean of communism, totalitarianism, cosmic corporate culture, cultism there. Oh my gosh, and we can't escape. Oh, the Red Sea parts, and we're able to escape. It's very symbolic, you see. Very symbolic. So this is a, now it's on as if I have warned, and hopefully prepared, and hopefully there'll be like a way to help others, you know, to help others sidestep this. I don't know. I'm not privy to the inside blueprint of that situation. I've only been told prepare, practice. That's it. So you're either wise or not, either wise up to it or not wise up to it. Again, it's a marketing campaign. Gradually they get you familiar with compliance, and then they super saturate. And this super saturation period is coming up, and we may even sidestep it coming up soon. I mean, I don't know what's going to happen in my situation. I don't know. I have not been told. I've been indications that perhaps there's some blueprint in place for helping us sidestep this. But I don't have any. Haven't gotten any direct, you know, information. So I'm just, you know, like shrugging my shoulders and wow, okay, yeah, what do you do about it? I don't know, but prepare. I know there's going to be some way to sidestep it. Just don't know, you know, exactly what it is. But it certainly looks like another place, doesn't it? I mean, that because global compliance is it's every kind, only country that's resisting seems to be Russia. and who knows why they're doing that? I don't know. Is it because they want to be the leaders telling everybody else what to do, or is it because they fundamentally ideologically oppose it, or you know whether? But they're the ones that seem to be not going along with the situation, which makes for a very tense Cold War situation with the world right now, actually, because they're isolating Russia and undermining its economy, trying to collapse Russia's economy and destroy their currency. It's a currency, it's a war with Russia right now, and you know who knows what Russia's going to do. Very dangerous situation. The world should not be acting this way. It's a very totalitarian way to act. Very, you know, radical. The approach the world's taking to Russia is very, very activist, very radical. And I think it's very ill-advised. Very dangerous. Very unfair too. I mean, there's nothing good about it, really. It's a radical, very radical approach that cosmic corporate culture is advising. You know, take this radical approach. It's not a loving approach at all. The world is not taking a loving approach at all to anything. They think that giving birth to this new age is love, 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 peace, love, love, flowers, love, love, you know, flower children, let's give birth to this new age. It's not love. That's not love. Love is to choose I am, which is to choose to be, to accept what we are, which is to choose absolute freedom. Absolute freedom is love. No structure, absolute freedom. There's no structure at all. No structure is love. Structuring, trying to structure what we are, trying to define we are, that's not love, that's hate. So basically we're calling hate love in this world. Got my golf gloves ready. I've got my new swing ready. It's a walk. It's a walk-through swing. It's a walk-through swing. It's a different swing than people use, which is when you swing, you're the right side. You just walk as if you're taking a step forward. You allow the momentum to carry you forward. It doesn't hurt your back. It doesn't harm your body so much. You see. So I'm ready to go. Call for the kingdom. Take it easy, or sidestep the carpet bombing of super saturation of radical activism. It's been made abundantly clear. There is going to be no resistance to this corporate super saturation carpet bombing compliance demands by cosmic corporate culture cultists, radical cultists. There's going to be zero opposition from the Chuck Snyder in the White House. There's going to be zero opposition from the Pope in the Vatican. And there's going to be zero opposition from the United Nations. And there's going to be zero opposition from almost every country in the world. That's already totally abundantly clear. So, you know, add up the, you know, equation. There isn't going to be any, you know, bureaucratic opposition at all on this planet. There's not going to be any institutional opposition whatsoever. Do the math on that one. I would say it's a good idea to sit out this saturation, carpet bombing, carpet bombed, super saturated advertising campaign. That's the next 18 months, because this will pummel any remaining resistance you have, so that you're going to be in that seat watching that movie when they tell you to. We haven't seen anything yet. The advertising campaign has been strong, but nothing compared to the super saturation. It's like radio stations. If you listen to them, there's something they want, you know, super saturate. Every half an hour, but sometimes then they get every 10 minutes, You know, it just pounds into you, and just you realize, wow, this is what's happening. This is the future. This is now. This is now. Actually, what they're telling you, this is now. And what are they doing? Birth of a new age. This is a huge, huge push by cosmic corporate culture to incorporate this planet. It, you know, so they're going to pull out all the stops. They're going to pull out all the stops now. Next 18 months, all the stops will be pulled out. So, oh, I pray that there's a house of hope for all of us where we can hang out and avoid this. Just avoid it. And just take it easy and not get into disagreements, ideological disagreement. That's not the purpose. The purpose is just to avoid it, the saturation. Be quiet. Get used to no structure. Just get used to no structure. Let the continuity fear just evaporate more and more and more. Like, oh, I don't need structure. Nothing needs structure. Reality doesn't need structure. Our reality doesn't need structure. Allness doesn't need structure. Pure potentiality doesn't need structure. I don't need structure. Just get used to that. Just get used to that. Jesus said the real world doesn't have any buildings at all. He says focus on buildings is a sure sign of confusion, spiritual confusion, attempt to have a co-identity. It's a focus on structure. And again, I was shown the world, this panorama of the world, how the world's obsessed with big, huge skyscrapers and you know, architectural buildings, structure. And the world's going to become absolutely obsessed. I once was shown the future, and I was shown this massive city for the future, and it was just incredible. It was like Chicago, you know, the skyscraper, but times, you know, 1,000. as far as skyscrapers everywhere, just massive, massive structures. Jesus says focus on architecture and structures, buildings, is a sure sign of deep, deep spiritual confusion and fear, continuity fear, very severe continuity fear. So I was shown all these structures, and I was on this cliff, and I was feeling like I was being falling into this cliff, and I was pulled back from it. And you got to pull back from structure, the obsession with structure. All the buildings of these, the obsession with building these huge, monumental structures, buildings, right, is a certain sign of severe continuity fear. And it's been pointed out, for instance, the presidential parliamentary building, like in Romania, is like the biggest building in the world or something, as far as mass goes or something. It was built during the communists, those who were extremely, had severe continuity fear, as a sign, you know, solidity of structure. We must have a solidity of structure. Now they're building massive, massive buildings in many places in the world now to celebrate structure, celebrate the birth of a new age, which is the birth of obsession with structure, believing structure is our salvation. Okay, this is what's going on in the world. I feel happiest, for instance, like I'm out on a golf course where you don't see any buildings anywhere, no structure, but it's still gentle, beautiful, lush, you know. I don't want to go in some terrible jungle, you know, where everything's confusing. No, this is, it's all peaceful, calm, see, unthreatening, you know, the whole thing is just like, wow. And you look around, it's just like no structure at all as far as buildings go. But there still is a structure of nature, but nature in like, as if there's no process taking place there, right? Because like on a golf course, you look and you see everything like looks like, wow, it's all fresh and new today. There's no sign of, you know, nature growing and overwhelming because the grass is cut every day. It's manicured, everything is, the trees are all, everything is, the flowers are just like, okay, so this is just how it is all the time, just like this. It feels that way. So it's kind of like a simulation of supernature. Golf courses are like that, depending on how you look at them. And of course, you can seem to still be engaged in some activity. So you say, well, yeah, I'm doing something. So, but at the same time, you're taking in this wow, this wowness. Hey, it's great to get away from buildings, isn't it? Yeah, it is. It's wonderful. And getting away from buildings doesn't have to mean living in some jungle, living in some wild mountain place or something, you know? No. Getting away from buildings can also mean living into some very gentle, beautiful, fresh place. Nature, free of process, free of process. And because we're so used to doing, we can be hitting a little ball around there and say, oh yeah, but what I like to do is just like stop somewhere and just say, nah, I'm gonna take a little break and just sit, watch, just sit by the stream here, do nothing. And then if people ask, oh yeah, I'm looking for my ball, I don't know, I hit it in here somewhere. And it's kind of, oh, okay. So sometimes I hit the ball, you know, off track, and so I can just go there someplace and just sit there, just say, wow, this is beautiful. No buildings anywhere. No buildings anywhere. Yeah, I got a lost ball. I don't know, I can't find it. Okay. And most of the people out there like that, like, most is like, yeah, it's no hurry. Take your time. Take your time looking for it. I like to go out in the summer. It's 113 degrees, 113 degrees, and nobody's out there. So you can look for your ball for like half an hour and just sit there in the golf court. Of course, the GPS is back at the clubhouse. It's showing you're behind schedule. Beep, beep, beep. You can just say, yeah, I just lost my ball. And I just, you know, couldn't find it. I wanted to find it. There's nobody behind me, so, you know, there's no pressure. Oh, okay. Or if someone comes along and says, hey, play through. If there's some obsessive compulsive, I gotta finish, let them play through. Go ahead. So I just get up the tee box and just sit there and just look out. You know, just wow, so beautiful. Eventually get around to hitting your tee shot. But the thing is just sit there and just look, wow, this is beautiful, beautiful. Who cares about a score? Who's keeping score? I don't know. I'm not keeping score. You can scribble something down if you want to. So I got the game, got the shots, got the swing, and body feels at least, you know, not too terrible. Anyway, this can be symbolic of sidestepping. Supersaturation is coming up, radicalism, radical activism is going to be saturating the world now, as it is already, right? I mean, it's just one thing after the other, after the other, after the other. Relentless every day. This is designed to collapse our spiritual will into compliance with confusion. It's designed, it's blueprinted to do this. This isn't something that's just happening to us for no reason. It is purposeful. It is designed by those who plan the future, those who are into structuring into structure. That structure extends into what they call time and space. How could you have structure if you don't have time and space? If there's no space, how can there be structure? Right? And if there's no time, how can you experience structure? How can you say you're experiencing structure if there's no time involved at all? Right? So time, space, and structure are all one delusionary belief system, along with process and form. How can you have structure if you don't have form? How can you have extension in space if you don't have process? How can you expand it, time, space, if you don't have process? So how can you work on structure? How can you work on definition if you're not having process? You cannot. So it's all one belief system. So it's going to be very interesting now what cosmic spiritual culture will do. I'm all ears. Well, okay. So, just keep trying to center yourself. I'm having trouble centering myself. Now that dream shook me up bad. That was a scary dream. But we're continuing here to clarify. So, all thanks be to cosmic spiritual culture, okay? We don't have to put a label on some teacher, this and that. All thanks to cosmic spiritual culture. You don't even have to say Holy Spirit. All thanks to cosmic spiritual culture, which is designed to help us evaporate the continuity fear of accepting no structure, that there is no structure. And in fact, ultimately, we realize there's never even been any structure. But that's beyond what we're aiming at right at this point. We're accepting the evaporation of continuity fear, accepting that I don't need structure. I don't need structure. This feeling, I don't need structure. Structure isn't needed. Getting used to that. Thank you, cosmic spiritual culture, for all the help that you've done and all the help that you are going to